when Janelle spoke to me about this course, it was interesting because only one person was going to gain. One person was going to be sent away and come back with information. And I thought it was very bold of you, Janelle, to ask FIFA to have a course for so many more. But you know what? FIFA is saying they want you to think outside the box. And this is outside the box, where we have so many more people taking part in a course that's going to help mold our young people. This course is going to be designed on four pillars: on leadership, which we believe, not just FIFA or CONCACAF, but TTFA, we believe is the number one pillar, because that helps our young ones. It guides them, it gives them a direction. Areas that are missing in our lives right now: management, how you manage yourself, how you manage people, how you manage teams. Teaching and coaching, best practices of what's done all over the world. And preparation and planning, areas that we take ad hoc. We don't put enough time and energy into preparation and planning. So this course will cover many areas. Again, I'm happy that I'm the one doing it. I feel because this is my country. I have gained so much coming out of here. Why can't I give back?
I'd like to acknowledge Janelle for this initiative. Wonderful initiative. Yeah, it's been a difficult 2 years trying to get settled on. I myself, I'm making no apologies, but it's taken a while to understand Trinidad football, get on top of Trinidad football, and more so the finances and the financial obligations of the association. This is a great initiative, and I hope it's the first of many to come. Welcome to this very special day as we open TTFA's C Coaching License course for women. The past 2 years have been challenging for everyone, especially so for persons involved in sport generally, and more so for us involved in football in particular, with all that's going on. Sport is intended to bring people together in a healthy rivalry. COVID-19 has done exactly the opposite. We are at last beginning to see some positives. There is some proverbial light at the end of the tunnel. The recent easing of restrictions on competitive sporting activity and the return of spectators to stands have been welcome developments, though it wasn't many people. And it came just in time for us to witness our senior women's national team defeat Nicaragua at the Hazley Crawford Stadium. We then went on to win against Dominica, and we are currently on the top of Group F with Guyana in the CONCACAF World Cup qualifiers. While there's some way to go, we must give credit where it is due. The team has performed admirably well. They've battled setbacks, injuries, COVID, red cards that shouldn't have been. And on behalf of all of us at the TTFA, I wish to extend congratulations to the women's team and coaching staff on the progress thus far. We hope they maintain the momentum and continue to succeed throughout the rest of the qualifiers. Additionally, our women's under 20 team, led by head coach Jason Spence, and the staff are preparing well and will begin their women's under 20 championships in a few days in Dominican Republic. It is good to have good things to say about women's football, especially on a day that is about women and football. Today, we make a welcome and positive step both for football and for women involved in football, as we open the TTFA C license coaching course for women.
As we say in football, not everybody can play. You know, somebody has to coach, somebody has to be the doctor, the physio, whatever it is. But this course here will give you the guidelines as to how we feel on the other side in order to make the players and the team function in the way that it should, because it's not an easy job, especially when you're dealing with cultures and, as the TD rightfully said, the leadership aspect, the management aspect. I think in coaching is most important, other than the teaching and coaching aspect. The leadership and the management aspect of it can make or break any team. And that is something you'll come to know over the course of your coaching career. So I do hope that with those that are here and those that will come later on, that you do take what is on board, you bring your own personality, your own thought process to what is being taught, and you do come out on top and inspire the next generation of players and even coaches.